Today, we're taking a look at application clay. It is a personal Rolodex, a private home for managing your relationships. It's sort of a productivity application, but it's something I've been quite interested in doing a review on for quite a while now, and I have managed to have a play around with the application to give you my perspective. So we're gonna be diving over major features, personal experience, and a score and summary near the end of this video. So if you wanna use the timestamps, feel free to. If you're new to Keep Productive, welcome. Keep Productive is a channel focused on helping you define the best productivity tools for work and life. So this is being called a personal Rolodex, the second half of LinkedIn, as they're quoting it on their website. And Clay has a beautifully designed iOS and Mac application, which is why initially it caught my attention. But this application is basically a way to see all of your contacts and relationships all in one. So when you get started, in terms of sort of major features, you basically connect your services like iMessage, calendar, email, and even things like Twitter. And it'll basically pull all of that information to create not only a social history, but updates and bios of that person in real time, which is quite nice, being able to sort of have that all in what side of one application. Now, the goal inside of Clay is to keep in touch with your contacts. So essentially it resurfaces them based on when you communicate with them and an algorithm around how often you should communicate with that person. And it's really interesting in terms of how the app's built, because you get this home feed where you can see a full outline of everyone you're communicating with, but how and often you should start talking to them. Now, the application does allow you to interact. So for example, you can go off into your email application, write an email to them, but you can also add notes allowing you to keep updated. Maybe they, you know, for example, you have a relationship that, for example, you wanted to write their kid's birthday or something where you don't remember it, but when next time you call, you've just got that to hand and sort of information all in one. So they also have a sort of social feed inside this application where you can see everyone's updates and highlights, but more in granular detail, where you, for example, you can see when somebody changes their Twitter profile and what they changed it to. Now, from using the application, some of my favorite things so far and the things that stood out for me was the cadence ability, the ability to resurface people based on how often you'd like to see them. For example, if somebody you don't necessarily talk to on a routine basis, like every month, you may want to set that to every 3 months, but you can change the cadence based and the frequency you speak to them based on each person. There is also a really nice command bar which allows you to do some really fast abilities. And as I said, the iOS and Mac application is really stunning in terms of its setup. So let's take a look at Clay as a summary. So this application is priced a little bit steeper. It's priced at $20 per month. And as you can imagine, that is quite expensive for a lot of people. That's why I think they're probably targeting a lot of their work towards VCs, investors, and those very much relationship management experiences. So for those who are in jobs that really require relationships first and foremost and being able to manage them. It's a little bit like Superhuman. They're targeting more of a premium audience where, for example, with Superhuman, their email is primary use and used quite a lot during the day. And this is probably the same sort of target market. This isn't necessarily a Zoho or Pipedrive competitor, but it stands alone in the market as a way to keep in touch with your contacts and build relationships. This application is really interesting, and in terms of its score, I'd probably give it an A for what it does. It is beautifully designed, and I really like the way that it's set up in terms of making sure you're keeping in touch with your contacts. One in particular recently, when I was using it, it resurfaced somebody that had changed jobs that was much more suitable for something I was doing right now in terms of being able to keep updated with them. And it was a perfect segue to be able to email them and see how things are going. So I guess it's really for a set target audience, but at the same time, I think the application is really well built and it definitely has an interesting place in the market. So folks, that was Clay. If you're interested in more app reviews, we're doing them very soon. So do check out the link in description and be a subscriber today. Thank you very much, folks. And I hope you enjoyed today's feature.